Good afternoon, everyone. This is Brother Lloyd, also known as 287. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, Shabbat Shalom. Today I'm going to do actually a couple of videos, but I wanted to do this one because it's going to be a relatively short video. I always say that, but it ends up being several minutes. But it's about David. Now, we were listening to a song, my family and I, we were listening to a song last night. And in the song, it mentioned that David had five stones. And we all know from scripture that David slew the giant Goliath with the first stone. So the narrator in the song, and actually it included a video, he asked children, he said, well, why did David have four more stones? And one of the children said, because David had brothers. And so that prompted me today to find out once again more about his brothers. Now, I had previously known that David slew Goliath's brothers because they were also giants. They were all Philistines and they were from a town called Gath. Now, this prompted me to research it again to find out how he actually slew them. So on my journey, I found out a couple of things. First, go with me to 1 Samuel 17:40 reads, and he took his staff in his hand and chose five smooth stones out of the brook and put them in a shepherd's bag, which he had even in a scrip. And his sling was in his hand, and he drew near to the Philistine. And the Philistine came and drew near unto David, and the man that bare the shield went before him. Then verse 42 says, And when the Philistine looked about, he saw David, he disdained him, for he was but a youth, and ruddy, and of a fair countenance. If we go down, verse 46, David says to him, he says, this day will the Lord deliver thee into mine hand, and I will smite thee, and take thine head from thee, and I will give the carcass of the hosts of the Philistines this day unto the fowls of the air, and to the wild beasts of the earth, that all the earth may know that there is God in Israel. So we go from there, we'll skip down a few verses, and we'll go to verse 50. And it reads, it says, so David prevailed over the Philistine with a sling and a stone and smote the Philistine and slew him. But there was no sword in the hand of David. So we know David took Goliath's own sword and beheaded him. Now, in 2 Samuel 21, remember Gath was the town that Goliath and his family was from. Verse 20 again, it says, and there was yet a battle in Gath, where was a man of great stature that had on every hand six fingers and on every foot six toes, 24 in number. And he also was born to a giant. Verse 21. And when he defiled Israel, Jonathan, the son of Shimeah, the brother of David, slew him. Verse 22. These four were born to the giant in Gath and fell by the hand of David and by the hand of his servants. So, 1 Chronicles 20, and we're going to start with verse 6. And it essentially says the same thing that we just read. It says, verse 6 reads, it says, and yet again, there was war in Gath, where was a man of great stature, whose fingers and toes were 24, six on each hand and six on each foot. And he also was the son of a giant. But when he defiled Israel, Jonathan, the son of Shimeah, David's brother, slew him. And then verse 8 reads, it says, these were born unto the giant in Gath, and they fell by the hand of David and by the hand of his servants. So, really in just a couple of verses, which takes some digging to get to, but within a couple of verses, you find out, for those of you who didn't know, Goliath did have brothers. They were giants. They were born of a giant, and they were from the town of Gath, and David did slay them. But it doesn't say whether he slayed them with stones or not. I read a lot of things on the internet, and there was really a lot of speculation about whether David actually slew the giants or not. But it's simply there in scripture, and it says, by David and the hands of his servants. So I don't even know where a lot of that speculation came from. Part of the point being is, people, you have to dig. You have to diligently search scripture. Scripture defines itself, people. So, with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is Brother Lloyd, 287. I'm out.